for that. Yeah.
Mjolnirs.
Mjolnirs. Go Dogs.
Opal is like, congrats, Opal. Also, we cannot wait for summer camp either. Y'all, what have you been up to? We'd love to hear, if y'all are joining us now, we'd love to hear what y'all have been up to. Go ahead and throw it in the Q&A. We can talk to you. But y'all, I think it is time for us to get started here today. So let's go ahead and get started. So guys, we've talked to y'all a little bit, but I want to hear what y'all are looking forward to this summer. What are y'all looking forward to? Ethan, you want to start for us?
Sure. I just can't wait for Rich Haven to start up, you know, so we can start working on some worship team stuff to help lead y'all in worship and get that all going. Can't wait for that.
Yeah, I'm so excited for that as well. Ethan, Becca, what about you?
I can't wait for real live barn sessions and all the lake games. I want to go down the slide so bad.
All of the lake games. All of them. Now, guys, Grayson, what do you got? What are you looking forward to?
I'm just looking forward to probably program and all the shenanigans that go down there.
Yeah. Yeah, it's going to be
what
great.
What program will be this year?
Yes, we have a lot of new stuff coming. Program, and we're also going to be singing some old favorites at camp this summer. One of them we're going to sing today when we worship one another. But yes, we are so looking forward to worshiping together this summer. And so, yeah, let's get into it. So all of us have Cameron's name. And some of you may be wondering, I know that that's Wesley and Ethan and Becca and Grayson and not Cameron. Well, the reason we're doing that is because, drum roll, today is Cameron's birthday. Woo! That's right. Cameron Anderson is turning a certain age this year, and we are going to do a game. I want to see if you guys know how old Cameron is. All right? So if you know how old Cameron is, I want you to throw it in the Q&A. Go ahead, get some guesses flying of how old Cameron is turning today. Who knows? Does anyone know? Any guesses? I haven't seen any guesses yet. Okay, here we go. 29.
Whoa.
26. 26. 24.
32.
We're seeing some guesses. 24. 26. Okay, seeing some guesses. Ethan, you got a guess? What do you think?
I'm going to say like 37.
37. Okay. 37, that might be a little high. We've got one guest, 43 years old for Cameron.
Becca, I think 43 sounds about right.
I mean, I was going to go like 35, but lots of people are saying 26.
You're saying 20. Ooh, 26. Grayson, what are you thinking?
I'm saying at least 45.
At least.
He's older than he looks, but.
Yeah, he really is. All right, here we go. Cameron, this year is turning, and not just this year, but today, is turning, drum roll, he's turning 26. Y'all got Woo! It. A lot of people knew that. The Reinhardts guessed 32. So, you know, he appears wiser than his 26.
And he is wiser than his
26 as well. So, awesome, y'all. Well, guys, we have some cool things to share with you. And we were sent this video by the Reinhardt family. They're on here, but I just want to, we're going to share this. It's a music video. And I honestly, it is one of the coolest things I've seen. So I am going to share this with you guys right now. I'm so excited. Here we go. Can y'all see this? Here we go.
Yeah!
Awesome. Thank you so much, Reinhardt family, for that. That is so awesome. Thank you for that. Now, guys, we have a special guest with us today. He has not been introduced yet. Okay, does anybody have any guesses on who this special guest is? Anybody? Let's see in the chat. Ethan, Grayson, what do you guys think? Any guesses?
Is it?
Oh, there he is.
Oh.
Anybody see him? No, oh! It's David! Hey, David. David, what do you got for us today?
Well, my name is Jungle Dave, and today I'm going to be talking about Hellbenders. So, it looks like Wesley is trying to share a picture of a Hellbender that I sent him, and it's going to come up sometime. Is Here it showing right now?
We will have it up in just a second.
We'll have it up in just a minute. Great. Okay. Well, in the meantime, I have not a real live Hellbender, but one right here in my hand that you guys can check out. It's a model of a Hellbender. And guys, these are a form of giant salamander. So I don't know if you guys ever caught a real life. I'm going to have to tilt this up. Becca's a little bit shorter than I am. I don't know if you guys have ever caught a Hellbender before. Or probably not caught a Hellbender, but if you've ever caught a salamander before, they're typically pretty small and a little bit, you know, slimy. You might find them in a creek or a puddle or something. So this guy is a form of giant salamander, okay? So there's a couple of different types of giant salamanders in the world, and this is the biggest one in the United States. And guys, they are just like a couple miles from Ridgehaven. So last summer, one of our camps, a junior high wilderness camp, got to go out and snorkel in a river just a couple miles from Ridgehaven, and we actually got to see these guys in real life, and it was incredible. Now, if Wesley will ever figure out how to show you another picture, you can see them a little better, but I'll show you it right here. These guys can grow up to be 3.5 feet long, which is insane. For a salamander, that's like just enormous. And what they do is these guys will live, there we go. Now we, I think you guys can see this picture. This is one that's living on the bottom of a river. And so you guys can see that these guys, they live almost their whole lives underwater. And they love just to explore the bottom of the rivers. Their main diet is crayfish, actually. And so they eat just tons and tons of crayfish. Sometimes they will actually, come out of the water, but that's pretty rare. Most of their life is just spent underwater. And they love to live underneath rocks, and they can pretty much only survive in fast-flowing alpine creeks. So you're not going to probably find one in your backyard creek at home. If it has a sandy bottom, you're probably not going to find them. If you come up here to Ridgehaven this summer, you might have a chance of spotting one. However, you're going to have to keep your eyes just absolutely peeled because, as you can see, they blend in super, super well with the bottom. God has designed them with this really amazing pattern that almost perfectly matches the bottom of creeks and the bottom river rock. And so they can blend in really well. Now, I'm going to do something kind of fun right now. There have been a lot of different nicknames for hellbenders over the years because they're such wild and crazy creatures. So if you guys can think of a great nickname for a hellbender, go ahead and type it in the comments and Wesley will read them in just a minute. A couple ones just to get you started. People have called them snot otters before because they're super slimy. If you're holding one in real life, it's almost like you're trying to grab a bar of soap because they're just covered in this mucus layer that allows them to slide beneath rocks and such. So that would be you could get a playoff of snot otter, whatever you guys are feeling.
Mud otters,
yes. They live less in the mud than they do in the rocks, but they do sometimes go into the mud. And they're actually hellbenders are what we call an indicator species. So they really rely heavily on the health of the surrounding ecosystem of the creek in order to survive. And the main reason that they depend on the stream being healthy is because they actually breathe through their skin. So I'm gonna hold this hellbender like this, and you can see these wavy sides on their skin are actually, they kind of look like lasagna, which people have called them lasagna lizards before, which is an interesting nickname. I don't know if I would pick that, but the reason they have these wavy sides is to increase the surface area of their body. Because they are absorbing oxygen through their skin, they want to have as much skin as possible, obviously, but they don't want to be these big bloated creatures just, you know, chilling around on the bottom of rivers. They need to be slim so they can slip underneath rocks. So they have this extra skin folds in order to increase their surface area. But if the water that they are living in is not polluted or has too much silt, which is just dissolved water in it, then they can actually not survive very well. So if you guys want to, a way that you can help hellbenders out is when you go to a river, first of all, don't pick up big rocks and move them around. I know it's fun to build dams and such, you know, to play in. But when you move those rocks, this hellbender, not this one because he is a fake hellbender, but the real hellbenders don't have a home to live underneath anymore. And so when you move that rock, it disturbs their home. You don't want someone to go to your house and picking it up and moving it, right? So don't move these guys' homes. And also be really careful if you're digging close to a creek or whatnot, make sure that you're keeping dirt from running off into it because that damages the environment they're living in. So Wesley, have there been any other ideas for nicknames before we go?
I got lasagna log.
Lasagna nickname. Log.
Billy the Bear. That. I got a lot of Billy the Bear nicknames. Thank you for that. Hillbillies is one of them. Spotted sliders. That's really interesting.
There we go. They are spotted. Cool. Yeah, good eyes. Whoever saw that, they have these spots, which again just helps them blend in with that creek rock on the bottom of the creeks.
Awesome.
Guys, that's just a quick snapshot of hellbenders for you. Come to Ridgehaven this summer and maybe you'll get to see one. Who knows?
Awesome. Thank you so much, David. Thank you, Jungle Dave.
Thank you.
We'll see you later. Now, guys, we've got We've got another interesting guest for us. So, guys, I don't know if you knew this, but Becca is learning how to play guitar. Becca is learning how to play guitar. And so Becca is going to play some songs for us. And your job is to guess what song she's playing, okay? So, Becca, we're going to play that first one. And then Ethan, Grayson, y'all can guess. And, guys, put in the Q&A what song you think. So, Becca, play that first song you've been working on for us.
Okay, I've been working really hard on it. Here we go.
Okay. So, any guesses as to what song that is? Anything, Grayson and Ethan? Anything? Any guesses?
Need a hint? You need a hint? This one goes out to Cameron. Cameron today.
Oh.
What is today for Cameron? Birthday. The birthday.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, there we go. Yay.
Yes, it was happy birthday.
Birthday.
Okay, this one's even better. I've really worked really hard on this one. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
It's my favorite song of all time.
What do you got, guys? What do you think? Anyone have any guesses? Jingle Bells is a guess. Interesting. Caleb, boy, got it. Caleb got it. It's Mary Had a Little Lamb.
Yes.
Oh, Caleb.
Yes, it sounds like it was hard to figure that out. That was so easy.
Caleb, that is awesome. Okay. Becca, you must be learning it pretty well then. All right. Yeah. That third song you got for us.
Okay. This is the last one and the best one. Are you prepared? Here we go.
Yes. Now Fount?
I don't think so. I Like Papayas, no.
What about
Uncle Archie, you have any guesses as to what this song is? He's got no guesses for us. Anybody? What is it? Anybody? I don't know. No, okay. Oh, we got it! The 500 miles!
Oh!
Awesome. Becca, thank you for showing us your new skills on guitar. Thank you,
Becca. It worked really hard. Really, really hard.
That is awesome. Okay, guys, now we have been compiling some videos of what people love about Ridgehaven. We're going to continue doing it, okay? So we're going to show y'all what we've been working on so far. This is just a lot of different people sharing what they love about RH. I just want to show it to you guys. But please feel free to send us a video. There'll be an email at the end for you to share that with. But I am so excited for you guys to watch this along with me here. If I can share it, just give me one moment as we figure this out. Again, thank you to the Reinhardts for sending us that awesome music video. We were just so thankful for y'all doing that for us. Here we go. This should work. Here we go. Still not working here. Let's see. We'll try one more time. Hopefully it will work for us this third time. Oh, is that, does everybody see it?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, here we go.
I just love Ridgehaven. I've been going there for 7 years, and I love the people there, and the worship team is just great, and I can't wait to see y'all there this summer.
My favorite part of Ridgehaven is session. The music is super fun, encouraging, and something you remember all year long.
I love Ridgehaven because it's so cool and unique to have a community to work alongside and have fun with and worship with, but that's also so encouraging, uplifting.
Hello, I'm here to tell you my favorite game in Ridgehaven. It is Mission Impossible. Let's go!
What do we look forward to most at Ridgehaven?
I like playing Gaga with all the different cats.
and I like playing Mission Impossible in the dark with all my friends.
So my favorite parts about camp are when you go to the lake and Mission Impossible and at Kai Summit when you're worshiping God.
This is Captain Horn, and my favorite thing about Ridge Haven is the community. I love how everyone comes together to learn and worship God in everything we do, and our games and activities and our bond sessions.
My favorite thing about Ridge Haven is just being able to get away from the world for a couple days and just grow my relationship with the Lord and just have some really awesome fellowship with other believers. It's just the most amazing thing.
My name is Isabel. I live in Fort Walton Beach, Florida, and I'm looking forward to Mission Impossible this year, Ridge Haven.
I love Ridge Haven because of the people.
Hey folks, Heather here. I love Ridge Haven for a lot of reasons. You know, the people, community, you know, everyone will say that, but the main reason is I love Ridge Haven for Scout. Scout's just the best thing that's ever existed. And I just want to say I love you, Scout. I miss you. I love Ridge Haven.
Hey, Ridge Haven family. It's me, Wesley. I'm just here to tell you all today that the thing I love most about Ridge Haven is being able to worship with everyone together at the Barn Center. Especially at Kai Summit. That's my favorite time of week. It's my favorite thing that we get to do.
My name's Esther. I live in Fort Walton Beach, Florida. And my favorite thing about Ridge Haven is Mission Impossible.
I love Ridge Haven for so many reasons, but one of the main reasons is some of the friendships that are made there, whether it's in the cabin or amongst the staff.
I love Ridge Haven because I formed some of my closest friendships there. And every year that I've gone, the Lord's used it to bring me closer to Him and learn more about Him.
My favorite part about camp is when you're setting up your bunk and you get to know everyone.
I'm Rachel, and what I love about Ridge Haven is the beautiful area that we get to be in and the people and the sense of community you have here.
My favorite part about Ridge Haven is that you learn healthy ways to have fun with your friends and you make great friends. But I love the Barnes Dance, the rope swing, Mission Impossible, and even when it rains, finding creative ways to have fun in the Barnes Center.
I love Ridge Haven because it is a place where I've been able to build such godly friendships with people that love me and continue to point me to God's love for me.
Hey, Ridge Haven, this is Matt Geringer. I was a camper and staff member at Ridge Haven for 9 summers. I haven't been to Ridge Haven in a few years, but By far my favorite thing about Ridge Haven, favorite aspect, is all the friendships I've made. Made new friends every summer I was there. Many of them have stuck with me and I still keep in touch with them. So that's my favorite thing about Ridge Haven. We'll see ya.
Awesome. Wow. Thank you to all of you that have already sent us videos. Please continue to send us videos. We love hearing from you about what you love about Ridge Haven and what you're looking forward to doing when we all get back here together. And with that, I'm gonna share some updates really quickly about what we are doing in the next few weeks. So first of all, Becca has already arrived. Becca is coming on full time with us here at Ridge Haven. We are so excited for Becca. She will be involved here in Brevard some, and eventually in Iowa at Kona, which we are so excited about. But we also have more summer staff coming on Friday. So we have 6 staffers arriving on Friday, and we will slowly begin receiving more staff over the coming weeks. We also, and this is really exciting, we have a couple of day camps coming in the coming weeks as well. We're implementing some social distancing strategies with them, and we are so excited to have guests back here at Ridge Haven. So yeah, we're so excited to share that news with you. And again, if you guys want to share those, what you love about Ridge Haven videos with us, please send them on over. And real quickly, I would love to hear what y'all have been up to really quickly. So guys, go ahead, post in the chat what you're up to right now. What are y'all up to? What's going on? What you been doing? Let's see here. Has anybody shared anything yet? I'm excited to see what y'all are doing. It doesn't look like we've seen much. Here we go. Oh, sleeping in till 10 o'clock. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it feels like we've all gotten a little more sleep lately with quarantine for sure. I don't know if that's been the case for you guys. Oh, playing with our dog. That is awesome. Ooh, Madeline says that they have built a giant slip and slide in their yard, which is cool because we've been building a giant slip and slide in our backyard here at Ridgehaven. We're so excited to show you guys this summer. We are working on it right now, learning how to drive. That is awesome, Amanda. I'm so glad for that. You've been learning American Sign Language, Annie. That is so great. That is awesome. Caleb Lloyd has been making a canoe paddle out of scrap wood and restoring an old fiberglass canoe. That is so cool. Opal, a lot of stuff. Ooh, brother. Ooh, taking care of a brother. That is awesome. And then making a zip line. So cool. The Reinhardts have been feeding their carnivorous plants flies. That is awesome. They have carnivorous plants and they've been feeding them flies. And I think down on the coast where the Reinhardts live, there's probably not a shortage of flies this time of year. The Waltons built a fire pit. That is awesome. Well, y'all, that is so great that y'all have been up to all this. I'm so excited for the coming weeks, and I'm so excited that we've been able to do these barn sessions with one another. And so, guys, I think it's a great time for us to get into time of worship. So we're going to begin that. Now, guys, this is, again, I loved hearing from people about worship and what they enjoyed from that, just from a lot of people. And I'm so excited that we have another time to worship with another. So we're going to start with this song. It's called the Papaya Song. Okay, so we'll bring it back. We got the slides coming up here in just a moment. So once these slides get up here, we will get into it. But we're so excited for this. Let's do it. So this song, I'll just walk you through it. So we'll start out with a little bit. It'll with a chorus, and then we'll speed up and slow down. So just get ready. It's a great worship song. So let's sing it. I like bananas. Doo doo doo. I think that mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Papayas. But nothing can beat the sweet love of God. Doo doo doo. Doo doo doo. Doo doo doo. Well, I was walking around in circles 5 miles an hour, trying to find my way back to my heavenly fire. World tasted sweet, but then it turned sour. I asked the man and received his power. Power, power, pie. I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet love of God. I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet love of God. I like bananas, doo doo doo. I think that mangoes are sweet. I like papayas, papayas. But nothing can beat the sweet love of God. Doo doo doo, doo doo doo, doo doo doo. Well, I was walking around in circles 5 miles an hour, trying to find my way back to my heavenly father. The world tasted sweet, but then it turned sour. I asked him in and received his power. Power, 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 I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet love of God. I like bananas. I think the mangoes are sweet. I like papayas. But nothing can beat the sweet love of God. Awesome. Now, guys, again, worshiping with one another is such an awesome thing that we get to do. In all over Scripture, we see people worshiping. This was a worship, a psalm for giving thanks. And there's so many things, even in this time when things are uncertain, there's so many things we've been given from the Lord that we can be thankful for. And so we are going to read this psalm together. So it's Psalm 100, 1 through 5. It's just five verses. So let's read this together. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. And he is faithful to us here, and we get to sing this song. This has come to be our theme song here at Rich Haven, Approach My Soul to Mercy Seat. It's written by John Newton, who lived long ago, and this song is written, he was also the writer of Amazing Grace, and he wrote Amazing Grace to show the power of the gospel and what that means for us. And this song shows the power of the gospel too, just in a slightly different way. It shows the power of the gospel in our everyday lives. When things happen to us in any circumstance of life, this is what we're called to do. We're called to rely on Jesus. And so this hymn is just a beautiful picture of the Christian life. And I'm so glad that we get to worship with one another. So let's sing. My soul, the mercy seat, where Jesus answers prayer. There humbly fall before his feet, for none can perish there. Promise is my only plea. With this I venture nigh. Thou callest burdened souls to be. Such, O Lord, am I. Thou down beneath the load of sin, by Satan sorely pressed. My war without and fears within, I come to thee for rest. I come to thee for rest. I come to thee for rest. Thou my shield and hiding, the shelter near thy side. I may my fierce accuser face, and tell him thou hast died. A wondrous love to lead and guide, bear the cross and shame, that guilty sinner such as I might plead thy gracious name. I plead thy gracious name. I plead I plead thy gracious name. For tempest-tossed soul, be still. My promised grace receive. As Jesus speaks, I must, I will. I can, I do believe. I must, I will. pray together. Dear Lord, thank you for giving us this season where we can join together online, worship with one another and have fun, play games. But most importantly, to remember what your son does for us on the cross. He dies and takes the punishment for our sin. Just help us to live an understanding of that truth and to let us understand your power over all circumstances, how you are able to work for us in ways we don't understand. And that no matter what, we always have the cross to rely on and depend on. Help us to do that. Help us to rely and depend on the cross. Thank you for giving us this time of worship. And we're so excited to see how you will exercise your glory here at Ridgehaven this summer. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Now, y'all, I'm so excited to welcome Uncle Archie back. One last time, he's here with me, and he's going to be sharing with us today. I'm going to hand it over to Uncle Archie. Thank you, Uncle Archie.
Thank you, Wesley. We're so thankful for you and each of our team members. Ridgehaven campers and family and friends, we thank Christ for you. And I have a request to make of you, a request of you that Paul in the Bible was a wonderful Christian man. He was a pastor. He was a preacher. He was a teacher. He was a missionary. And he made a request of others that I am asking you to do. Boys and girls, of adults of all ages, we see in Scripture that Paul asked for prayer. He asked people to pray for him, not just for him, but for the ministry. And I want to share with you a prayer he made for his friends in the city of Philippi. It comes from Philippians chapter 1, verse 9 and following. Paul told his friends in Philippi that he was praying for them, and then he gives us his prayer that he was making for them. This is his prayer. And it is my prayer that your love may abound more and more with knowledge and all discernment, so that you may approve what is excellent, and so be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. So campers, family, friends, will you consider praying for yourself, for your own family like this, for those of your church, there where you live, for us of Ridgehaven, and yes, Christ's family throughout the world. Three requests that we see in this one prayer. The first is to know God's best, meaning understand God's best. The second request is to experience God's best. And then lastly, to share his best with others. You need this. Your family, your church family, those throughout the world. And yes, we of Ridgehaven need to know and understand God's best, that we may love you and care for you. We're excited about the ministry Christ has this summer through Ridgehaven. Wallace Anderson, our executive director, Cameron Anderson, our director, Jesse, Wesley, our whole team, Grace, our counselors, our staff, to understand God's best. How do we best serve you? That's what Paul is praying. And it is my prayer that your love may abound more and more with knowledge and all discernment. Knowledge, all discernment. Lord, how do we best serve? Give us understanding that we may properly care for you who come, care for you spiritually, care for you medically, emotionally, in every way. We need the ministry of prayer. Paul understood that. We're wanting to understand it. Again, pray like this for your own family, for your leaders there in your church, and for Christ's family throughout the world. We need, Lord, to understand your best. Secondly, to experience your best. Not only understand it, but then to experience it, to live it out. Here's the prayer again. Verse 9, Philippians 1, 9. And it is my prayer that your love may abound more and more with knowledge and all discernment. There it is, understanding. So that, not only to know it, so that you may approve what is excellent. To understand God's best so that you can experience it and live it out. Please, whatever your age, your prayers are important. Your prayers as a boy, as a girl, as a child, as a camper, are just as important as anyone's prayer when you come through Christ. See, that's the reason we pray. We pray through Jesus Christ. It's his life. Remember, Jesus Christ is God-man. He's deity. He's God, but he became a human. He became a person, and he lived that perfect life. And he willingly accepted God's punishment against sin. He willingly accepted God's wrath and judgment against sin that he did not deserve because he never sinned. Jesus was perfect. Perfect in everything he said, thought, and did. But he accepted God's punishment in order to give his own perfection by his resurrection. By his resurrection, we can have the perfection of Christ when we are repenting of our sin, turning from our sin, and turning toward Christ. The word is repent and believe. Are you repenting? Are you turning toward Christ? Are you turning from going your own way? Jesus said, come after him. Deny yourself. Take up the cross daily. Daily. And follow him. Will you please, again, for your own family, for those in your church, for those of us at Ridgehaven who be here now and hopefully this summer, in the ministry, Lord, to understand your best in order to live and experience your best and share your best with others. Listen to the way he closes. So that you may approve what is excellent, and so be pure and blameless for the day of Christ. Growing in Christ, growing in the grace and knowledge of Christ. Filled, here it is, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of Christ. Of God. God the Father can make us righteous with him as he works that in us to repent of our sin and believe on Christ. Christ accepting the punishment we deserve. Christ giving his own righteousness by his resurrection. Oh, I'm glad we're together. Let's pray. Father, thank you. Thank you for Christ never, ever sinning yet accepting the punishment against sin that he did not deserve. And Father, you made him live again. You resurrected him that we may receive his perfection. Enable us to repent of our sin, to believe on Christ and pray. Father, I pray for these, our campers, our friends, those in their church, our leaders through our nation and throughout the world. Please let us understand your best, to experience your best in decisions that are before us, in order to share your best. Thank you, Father, for Christ, in whose name and authority we pray. Amen. Rich Haven family, friends, campers, we're so thankful for you, and our Lord willing, look forward to a good time here at Rich Haven, hopefully with you and others. Okay? Bye-bye, guys. Bye-bye.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Uncle Archie, and thank you all for tuning into these online barn sessions. In a way, it's a little sad to be moving away from this, but we're so excited to do ministry once again in person this summer. So thank you to Uncle Archie, to Cameron, to all of our guests. We had Kelsey on, Lily, Kat Smith, and many others. Thank you all. For joining and helping Ethan, Grayson, Becca, David. I could keep going on and on about the many people in this Rich Haven family that have tuned in and been a part of this. So thank you so much. Please send us those videos. I'll tell you all the email to send the videos to, just of, you know, what you love most about Rich Haven and are excited for. So again, Cameron@richhaven.org. Email them to Cameron, cameron@richhaven.org. We will get those videos compiled and we will post it hopefully in the next week. And we'd love to have your submission. So thank you all so much for joining. And until next time or this summer, we'll see you later. Bye. Thanks, guys. Y'all. Bye, everybody.
Bye.